we've seen our bodies lifted. Lord, we thank you in anticipation, knowing that you have brought us thus far to where we are today. Lord, we rejoice knowing that grace is what has kept us. Grace is what is teaching us. Grace is what is sustaining us. The grace of God, which is the person of Jesus Christ, has appeared to all men. Lord, we embrace this appearance. We embrace this revelation of Christ. Lord, there is no other revelation than the revelation of Christ that was given to man when the Word became flesh and dwelt in our neighborhood. When the Word walked into our neighborhood, walked into our sphere, and had empathy and had experienced what man experienced. Lord, you that couldn't die, enter into the region of death. You entered into the experience of death for all man. You tasted death for all man. All mankind that can don't have to taste the death you tasted. You tasted and went into the experience of death itself, the experience of eternal separation itself, for my sake and for the sake of all mankind. We embrace this appearing of grace. You went into this place. You are the guiltless one, yet you became the guilty one for my sake, so that I will be declared not guilty. Lord, you are. This is what grace has revealed to us. This is the appearance of grace that has taught us. Lord, we embrace this appearance. We embrace this revelation that we are no longer held in contempt with the court of justice in heaven. We are no longer held in accusation with the court of heaven in heaven. Lord, no accusation will hold water against us. Lord, the enemy has taught us lies and told us that we are accused because of our flaws. No, the blood is taking care of our flaws. The enemy has lied to us that we are accused because of our shortcomings. No, the blood has taken care of that. The enemy has accused us because of the flesh. No, the death has taken care of the flesh. Lord, everything that the enemy has accused us of, Lord, I've been taken care of on the cross. When you declared it is finished, it was that reality that you have spoken to. Lord, for everyone who embraces and believes that, you said we are now set free and saved. And so we took our trust and I embrace our salvation. We embrace you, our salvation. We embrace you, our deliverance. We embrace you, our freedom. We embrace you, our liberty. We embrace you, our joy. We embrace you. Everything that we need for life and godliness is in you, because you are much more than what we can ever ask or imagine. So in you, we live in you, we move in you, we have our eternal being. We embrace you as our life. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for this wonderful privilege, that of your grace that you have imparted to us. You say your strength is made perfect in our weaknesses. Your grace is sufficient unto us. Lord, we know of a surety that your grace is sufficient. It satisfies. It is the satisfaction that our soul longs for. It is the satisfaction that our hearts crave for. It is the desire of our heart, the desire and the longing of every man, every woman. And that's why we lay hold on many things, thinking that that will satisfy us. We've been looking for the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. We've lusted after things, thinking they satisfy. But Lord, we've only come short and only come hungry and more thirsty. But Lord, you said those who hunger and thirst after righteousness, the right thing. You are our righteousness. Those who hunger and thirst after you shall be filled. Lord, we hunger and thirst after you. We hunger and thirst after the reality of knowing you as one with you, of coming into this oneness, this relationship with you. We thirst after you. We embrace this reality. We embrace our union, hallelujah, that it is inseparable, our union of inseparability from you. Lord, we are one with you. You are our head. You are the headship of our life. You are the headship of our tomorrow. You are the headship of every desire and everything in our lives. And so we take our divine instruction and divine guidance and directions from you. Headship is what you are to us. You head over every affair of our life. No man has the authority over our lives, but you are the head of our lives. No circumstance has the authority over our lives. You are the head of our lives. No situation has the authority over our lives. You are the head of our lives. Because we take headship from you, we are rest assured that we are secured, because you are the unfailing one. You are the faithful witness. Even when we deny you, even when we deny ourselves, you can't deny yourself. You are such a being that cannot deny who you are. Your love is what transcends creation, transcends eternity. Lord, it will take eternity to unravel the depths of your faithfulness and the depths of your love for us. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for such a privilege to walk in grace. grace. Lord, we have entered and walked throughout this week in grace. Grace has taught us. Grace has been much more abound when sin reveals itself. Every time the flaws of sin and the mistakes of sin and the accusation of sin and the condemnation of sin and everything around us, which is the result of sin, begin to pop up, grace shows up and says, grace is much more abound. Grace is much more abounding. That's why we are healed from sickness. Grace is much more abounding. That's why we can be provided for. Grace is much more abounding. That's how our eyes of understanding can be opened. Grace is much more abounding. That's why we can know things that we have not learned and understand things we have not read. Lord, grace is much more abounding. That's why the wisdom of God floods our heart. Grace is much more abounding. That's why we can be bold and confident, knowing that nothing is impossible unto us. Lord, we thank you. We thank you because everything that we have set our hands to do throughout this week has prospered. We enter into rest in our homes. We enter into rest in our bodies. We enter into rest in our finances. We enter into rest in our lives, because in you we have rest. There is rest around about. We enjoy the shalom of God, the rest of God. Everything that is missing and everything that is broken is now fixed, because in you there is no missing piece. Hallelujah. We are perfect and complete in Christ. There is no missing piece, nothing disjointed, no joint that is not functioning in you. Everything receives its life source, its life bearing from you. And so we thank you, Lord. Mashekri kombari kalabadosi rabadishe pratalabadoso ingratalabashere. Lift up your voice and begin to rejoice. Manda kalabosh improto labanish imprata labadosa. Andalama, all we need is in him, and in him we live. Hallelujah. Because I am in him. He said, because I live, you shall live also. What a pronouncement of commitment. What a declaration of that cannot be changed. Because he's alive, nothing around me dies. Because he's alive, nothing around me is unproductive. Because he's alive and he's alive. Not just in heaven, but is alive in me. As he is, so am I. Nothing in me will die. Nothing in me is unproductive. So everything in me is quickened by the life of God in me. My body is quickened. My health is quickened. My mind is quickened. In the name of Jesus. Nothing in me is shortcoming. Nothing in me is out of order. Because he is in me. He is the head of my body. Hallelujah. I am the body of Christ. I am the body of the living one. The one who is alive. I am the physical expression of the divine one on the inside. Hallelujah. The Bible says that he that is joined to the Lord is one spirit with him. I am one spirit with him. But out of his fullness I receive grace upon grace, grace upon grace, grace upon grace. My spirit is filled with the spirit of Christ. My spirit is soaked in the spirit of Christ. There is such a oneness between me and the spirit of Christ that you can't separate us. Hallelujah. Just like hydrogen and chlorine, I am, and the spirit of Christ are one. We are so in tune that I hear his voice louder and clearer than any other voice, than any voice and any counsel, any other opinion in this world. His counsel is louder. His opinions are louder. His thoughts which are higher is now my thoughts. My thoughts are now higher. His will, which is confirmed, his will that can never fail, has now become the will and the motivation of my life. It's now becoming what drives me now, what wakes me up. I am strengthened by purpose. I am quickened by purpose. I am quickened by the will of the Father. I live for his purpose and eternal reason. That's why I can live beyond time. That's why time cannot restrict me. That's why my location cannot limit me. That's why my education cannot put me behind, because I live in purpose. I live in the will of the Father. And because I'm a son of God, everything responds to the sonship in me. Responds to the son that I have become. Responds to the son that I am. In the name of Jesus. Hear ye the word of the Lord. Because I am a son of God, all things are possible unto me. I live by the will of the Father. I live by the counsel of the divine one. I live by the grace and the strength of the one who conquered death and conquered the grave on my behalf. So because he conquered death in and for me, death has lost its sting over me. Death has lost its hold over me. Death and the mystery of death, the power of death, the power of the grave, has lost his influence over my life. Life is now at work in me. I have eternal life at work in me. Eternal life that is working in me, keep delivering me from that which is corruptible. That which is corruptible. I am possessed by the incorruptible one. I am possessed by the one who knows no corruption. So there is not any sign of incorruptibility in my flesh. That is why my body is quickened. That is why my body is energized and quickened by the life of God. My cells are being quickened. My eyes are being quickened. My arteries are being quickened. My liver is being quickened. My kidneys are being quickened. Hallelujah. My lungs are quickened by the life of God. My tissues are quickened. My blood vessels are quickened. My heart is quickened. In the name of Jesus, my hearing is quickened. My hair is quickened. Hallelujah. My nails are quickened. Hallelujah. I am the quickened one. I am the quickened one. And because I'm the quickened one, every part of me is quickened and alive. Alive unto God. It's alive and connected. There is no disconnection in my life. No disconnection in my relationship with the Father. I am in eternal fellowship, uninterrupted, unlimited fellowship. Because I live in this quickened state, everyone I touch becomes quickened. Hallelujah. Just like the woman with the issue of blood touched Christ and her body was quickened. Even if the sick touch me, their bodies are quickened. Oh, payata labatoa. I can lay hands on the sick and they recover because I live a quickened life. Hallelujah. I can cast out devils because I live a quickened life. When I speak a thing, it is done because I live a quickened life. I live, life has possessed me. Life has taken a hold and the control over my life. Life has taken a hold and the control over my will. Life has taken a hold and the control over my thoughts and my desires. Life has taken hold over me. Eternal life is at work. The incorruptible eternal life is at work in me. In the name of the Lord Jesus, my tissues, no disease can survive in my cell. No disease can survive in my tissues. But eternal life will kill it. Hallelujah. Eternal life will swallow it up. The incorruptible will swallow that which is corruption. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, all things are possible unto me. The eternal one is working at work in me, but to will and to do and of what pleases him. So I live in the pleasing face of the Father. I live always pleasing the Father. My will is the will of the Father. My thoughts are the thoughts of the Father. My heart are the heart rate of the Father. I see all mankind like my Father sees them. He sees them in Christ. I see them in Christ. I do not see them in their flaws because their flaws was covered by the blood and the sacrifice. I see them as Christ sees them, redeemed but don't know. Redeemed but, and with compassion I rescue them. I rescue them from the place of death. I rescue them from the place of corruption. I rescue them from the place of separation. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. You are faithful. This is truth. These are eternal truths. We are bound by, we are swallowed up in, we are quickened by. Thank you, Lord. The truth that makes free is now the truth that guides our life. The truth is now our life. The truth is no longer a doctrine, not a sermon, not a teaching, but is who we are. We are now the truth exemplified. We are now the truth revealed. We are now the truth in our going out and in our coming in. We are now the truth when we lie down, because we are the truth, we are walking in the freedom and the liberty of sons of God. Everything around us experiences and is emboldened and covered by the truth that we have become. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, Bashimbra Talamanusa Kayara, Shedebodosa, Yerebodobushimbra Talamanana. Learn to speak over yourselves, speaking to yourself in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. Make a melody in your heart. The melody of God's heart is the melody of the finished work. That is what excites God. That is the joy of God's heart. And as you begin to embolden yourself in it and embrace it in your declarations, you will see that the life of God will find expression in your environment. In the name of Jesus, I bring you good news. Walk in dominion. Walk in the freedom that God has given you. Don't allow anyone steal that which God. Jesus said that I have come to give you life. The thief comes to steal. The thief is not just one devil coming out to steal something, no, steal your car. See, that's minimal. That's not there. The thief comes to steal the truth that you know. He comes to steal it by wrong information, wrong doctrines, misinformation, a mixture of the truth and a lie. That's how the thief steals from you. Because if he can still stop the truth from coming to you, it can keep you perpetually in bondage. But good news is that the truth is now flooding the earth like the waters cover the sea. The truths are flooding our hearts, are flooding our minds, are flooding. The truth of Christ is flooding your heart, flooding your home, flooding your experiment, flooding your environment, flooding everything around you. This truth will not escape you. You will not escape from the truth. You can't escape from the truth. You can't do anything against the truth but for the truth. So nothing can stop the truth that is coming into your heart, coming to your space, coming to your mind, coming to your life, and coming to your experience. Nothing can stop the truth from finding expression around you. Nothing. Hallelujah. That's the good news I brought to you today. It's a beautiful day. I will see you again as we continue our journey in the growth of grace in Christ Jesus on Prayer Banquet. Amen. Share this information out. Share the truth out. Sell the truth or share the truth. And don't, it's free. Christ made it free for every one of us. Amen. I'll see you again. God bless you and have a splendid and beautiful day ahead. In Jesus' name.